proving what is acceptable unto the Lord, and have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them. For it is a shame even to speak of those things which are done of them in secret, but all things that are reproved are made manifest by the light. For whatsoever doth make manifest is light. Welcome to another edition of Floor of Wisdom Radio. I am your host, Sean Anthony. We do this show live every Sunday, 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on the Genesis Communications Network. So thank you all those that are tuned in, listening on GCNlive.com around the globe on the internet. And, you know, today's my guest, I think it's her third time joining the show, Miss Cisco Wheeler. She is an author of numerous books, one of them entitled Behold a White Horse. Also, she co-authored Total Mind Control Slave, the Illuminati formula to create an undetectable total mind control slave. And she's joining me again today. We're going to cover some quite interesting topics. As I tweeted out earlier before the show, the enemy is not going to like this particular show, because when you start to expose the enemy, because for those that follow Flow of Wisdom Radio, you guys know that, you know, we cover things. I'm not afraid to touch on things, you know, from a spiritual nature. And we don't fight against flesh and blood. We fight against principalities and things of that are not in a physical realm. The root of the things that we fight come from the spiritual realm. It's a spiritual warfare that we're constantly in. But we're going to touch on some other things, such as the Ebola virus, EMP threat, you know, the power grid. But we're going to really expand on some things that I would say is going to be a in-depth conversation. So I want to welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio, Cisco Wheeler. How are you today, Cisco? Hello? I don't hear her. Okay. All right. My producer's telling me in my ear that she just hung up, and we're going to get her back on. See, and this is a perfect example of what I was just saying. That's why I opened up the show the way I did. Because when you come with certain things, when you come with certain truth, and the enemy knows, the enemy's gonna try to do anything possible to distract or deter. But you know, I've been doing this for some time, so I'm a professional, and I know how to keep it rolling. So Cisco, we got you on now.
I have you on, but I cannot hear you.
Okay, she can't hear me, she says. So. I don't know. Is there anything on our end, Scott, that we can do?
It's like a whisper. When I talked to Scott, it was just as clear as a bell, but I can't hear you.
Okay.
I mean, it's just at a whisper.
Okay. Okay. Scott's going to be working on that in the background. Cisco, can you hear me a little bit at least?
A little bit, yes.
Okay. Well, I just welcomed you back. So welcome back to Flow of Wisdom. Let's just go ahead and start this off, Cisco. I have a few minutes here in this opening segment. So just go ahead and share with my listeners some of the information that you would like to touch on today.
Okay. I would like to talk about the Serpents of Wisdom, and I want to introduce the radio audience to Earth power grids and what they have to do with what is going on in the interstellar activity around the world and within witchcraft, and how it all works together. But
now,
before I go into that, Sean, I'd like to remind our listeners that God loves each and every one of us so much. You know, from the foundations of the earth, before he made the earth, he created the souls of man, and he loves each and every one of us so much. And what I'm going to share with you is very dark, very deep, and it's going to shake a lot of you up, but it's also going to give you the wisdom you know that you need in order to fight the enemy that is here and is going to be released upon the earth. But before I go into that, I want to remind you of a beautiful scripture. And I titled my book, Behold a White Horse, because I know that Yeshua HaMashiach, he is coming back. I want to read the scripture that refers to his coming. heaven open, and behold, a white horse. And he who sat on him was called Faithful and True, and in righteousness he judges and makes war. His eyes were like a flame of fire, and on his head were many crowns. He had a name written that no one knew except himself. He was clothed with a robe dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God. And the armies in heaven, clothed in fine linen, white and clean, follow him on white horses. Now out of his mouth goes a sharp sword, and with it he should strike the nations, and he will rule them with a rod of iron. He himself treads the winepress of the fierceness and wrath of Almighty God. And he has on him his robe, and on his thigh a name written. Then I saw an angel standing in the sun, and he cried with a loud voice, saying to all the birds that fly in the midst of heaven, come and gather together for the supper of the great God, that you may eat the flesh of kings and the flesh of captains and the flesh of mighty men, the flesh of horses and those who sit on them, and the flesh of all men, free and slave, both small and great. And I saw the beast and the king of the earth and their armies gathered together to make war against him who sat on the horse and against his army. Then the beast was captured, and with him the false prophets who worked signs in his presence, by which he deceived those who received the mark of the beast and those who worshipped his image. These two were cast alive into the lake of fire, burning with brimstone, and the rest were killed with the sword, which proceeded from the mouth of him who sat on the horse, and all the birds were filled with their flesh. We have a God that is coming back. Yeshua HaMashiach will come with the armies, with the saints of God. And, you know, I know that a lot of us are going to give our life in the days ahead. But, you know, we win either way. We win. If we are allowed to live and go through the tribulation, we win. If we're serving God and we don't take that mark. And if we should die, we still win because we get to come back to be with the Lord in his armies. So we're winners. So we have a lot to look forward to. In either life or death, we have a lot to look forward to in Christ Jesus. Now I'm going to go on and I'm going to talk about ritual magic. And again, I want to remind you that this is a very, very deep subject. It's a hard subject to bring clarity to those that are listening over the radio because it's such a deep subject. But I will do my best, and I'm just hoping that I can open up a door of thought within your own mind so that you can understand things at a deeper spiritual level, because this is all at a spiritual level that we're fighting against the principalities of darkness in high places.
Now, real quick, Cisco, before you begin, let me just let my listeners know just a little bit brief background on you. Cisco Wheeler, as I stated in my opening statement, she is, you know, an author of a book entitled Behold a White Horse and also Total Mind Control Slave. But her background, briefly, without deviating from the time to take away from the topic, Cisco grew up in the occult, the Illuminati. Her father was a full-blown Satanist, and she was used and mind-controlled, MK-Ultra, and all these crazy things. She got out of it, and she's turned her life over for Christ, and she's been proclaiming the glory of Christ since then. And, you know, since then she's been exposing the enemy. But just to give you guys perspective who may not be familiar with Cisco Wheeler, again, I've interviewed her a couple of times, so you can always go to flowofwisdom.com to check out those previous interviews. So, Cisco, we have about 4 minutes left in this break, so go ahead. Well, actually, a couple of minutes, so go ahead.
Okay, can you hear me okay?
I hear you loud and clear.
Ritual magic, also known as ceremonial magic, it's been practiced throughout the ages and is still being practiced today. I want you to remember it is still being practiced today. Magic has not gone away. Within this great white brotherhood, our comradeship is a global elite inner circle referred to as the Serpents of Wisdom. The Serpents of Wisdom. These serpent dragons can be found around the globe in places such as Israel, Paris, the United States, Africa, India, China, Japan, Peru, Greece. I could go on and probably I'll just say et cetera, okay? These adepts are like an interwoven blanket where every stitch is interlocked until a blanket is neatly woven. Their spiritual thread has subtly linked most religious traditions together throughout the church and within society, as they have blatantly enmeshed the old pagan traditions and holidays within Christian symbolism and ceremonies. In other words, they have set the foundational structure for the churches, within government, within the school systems, within life in general. They have set the platform from which we live and how we think. This incorporated stitch I'm referring to is that ever-present icon of the serpents and how it is associated with a great master and adepts around the world. I'll say it again. They're associated with the great masters and the adepts around the world.
All right, well, hang tight, Cisco. We got to take a commercial break. And, you know, I'm going to give you the time that you need to continue on, but just hold your finger on right where you are. Ladies and gentlemen, you don't want to miss this show because it's the reason why we're going to expose all of this, because I don't want you to think that I'm just highlighting evil. So there's a purpose behind what we're doing today. Stick around. I'm Sean Anthony. This is Floor of Wisdom Radio. Flow like the blood of Abraham. This is for you, dearly beloved. Yeah, this show is definitely for you, dearly beloved. Welcome back to Floor of Wisdom Radio. I'm your host, Sean Anthony. My guest today, Cisco Wheeler, author of Behold a White Horse. She was just beginning to scratch the surface on a deep topic we're going to talk about today, amongst many other things. But right now, I want to give Cisco the floor. Cisco, this is a short segment, about 5 minutes. So okay. I want to give you the opportunity to pick up where you left off about this ritual magic that is still going on today and just exposing the enemy. So go ahead. The floor is yours.
Okay. I'm going to back up just a little bit so we can remind the listener as to what I was talking about. This incorporated stitch that I'm talking about, it's an ever-present icon of serpent power and how it is associated with the great masters and the adepts around the world. Traditionally, these great masters and adepts have been universally linked with snakes, serpents, or dragons. Each of these symbols have been referred to by provincial names that mean serpent. They have been called Nagai in India, the Adder in Great Britain, and they have names for these snakes and dragons, okay? Because they are basically demons, okay? These serpent dragons have shared their sacred wisdom throughout all the ages of time. This wisdom has led the world on a quest to attain spiritual enlightenment. Remember, when you hear that word enlightenment, the children hear it at school, we hear it on, I don't hear it because I don't watch TV, but in the past I have heard the word, the term enlightenment. Stay away from it, it's poison. Serpent dragons have such spiritual enlightenment, they have become Andronius while existing within a literal male or female body. Should I say that again?
Please.
They have obtained spiritual enlightenment to the point that they become Andronius. These demons can dwell, or these aliens can occupy and take over a body. And that individual that is being taken over is no longer themselves. They are totally demonically controlled. They literally can take over a male or a female body. And in this state, they become gods. They are gods to the nations. Many of these individuals within the leadership of all countries, they are no longer themselves. They are totally been taken over by demonic entities. They exercise unrestricted serpent wisdom and power because they have been taken over. These individuals have the power and the knowledge and the wisdom of the serpents. They have the aptitude to materialize into any physical object at will, even to the point of going through walls. That should spark some thinking in some people's minds that have heard of alien abduction and them coming through walls. The serpents of wisdom dwell within an unchangeable physical body that can stay alive for hundreds and thousands of years. So these people that have been taken over, you've probably heard that some people have lived for hundreds of years, they don't die. Well, they don't die because these demons have literally taken over their bodies. Okay?
Yeah, well, let me stay right there for a second, Cisco, okay. Because we're coming up on a break here. It sounds like these demonic beings, you know, some people have referred them to being as aliens, because I've even had conversations, even guests on the show that has had encounters with them. And they've said some of the, as far as the characteristics which you're mentioning, they've mentioned that these aliens or extraterrestrials have the same type of characteristics as far as telecommunication, speaking without using their mouths, or they don't have a mouth, and just speaking, mentally, going through objects, through walls and stuff like that. And even when I interviewed Trey Smith about the Book of Enoch and other things, he alluded to some of the same things that you're mentioning about the serpent. So we're going to come take a break, come back, have a longer time to talk. Very interesting topic. My guest, Cisco Wheeler. I'm Sean Anthony. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. Welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am Sean Anthony. My website is flowofwisdom.com. If you're just tuning in, my guest, Cisco Wheeler, joining me, author of Behold a White Horse, also co-authored Total Mind Control Slave. You know, we do this show live every Sunday, 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Some heavy discussions going on right now. Interesting topic. Cisco has been talking about ritual magic that has been going on right now, talking about the serpents of wisdom and extraterrestrial beings or demonic beings that can shapeshift and go through physical objects and all kind of different things. Cisco, for the listeners out there that's probably thinking, wow, this is some heavy stuff. Is this stuff really real? What do you say to them?
It's very real. It's what makes it's the spiritual forces that control the world as a whole. This is what controls the world in the demonic realm.
Well, let's go ahead and pick up where we left off with some of the information that you were sharing, Cisco.
Yes, you were very correct in what you said before you took your break. The dragon body experiences a supernatural intelligence of clairvoyance, clairaudience. They can hear, they can see, they know all things. They have a sense of transference within the makeup, what makes them what they are. At all times, they're in communication with each other. And this gives the serpent dragon the power to stay in continuous communique with the spiritual realm, which encircles and interpenetrates the physical plane. Okay? And at will, these serpents have the power to leave or extricate the dragon body from its physical sheath and journey within it to far, far away places throughout the cosmos. So they can take any form they want. They can shift shape into anything they want to be. So they can be here and there at will, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Because these serpents of wisdom live in a high frequency, physical form or dragon body, they're in sync with the subtle vibrations surrounding them, This is really important for you to remember. The dragon body they're in has to be in sync with the subtle vibrations surrounding them. It's very important to their well-being that they build structures and landscapes which generate vibrational fields which were calming and spiritually inspired to their own kind. Do you know what I just said, John?
Yeah, yeah.
Can you explain that?
Well, repeat. I want you to repeat that.
Okay, I'll try to. Okay. These serpents of wisdom live in a high-frequency physical form or dragon body. It's very important that you remember that. They have to be in sync with a vibration that surround them. They have to be in sync with it.
Right. So let's talk about this, Cisco.
Okay.
The symbolisms, like when we talk about like Washington D.C.
Mm-hmm.
and how the entire city of Washington D.C. has all of these occult symbolisms. The obelisk, you know, how the Masonic outline and structure of the streets and the different monuments, if you will, that's in the nation's capital is located. Is that the type of vibration that you're referring to? Because I remember, I think I read something you sent me, and you were talking about how certain things that are written, these symbols that are written, are very powerful and has some sort of energy. Is that what the direction that you're referring to? You want to expand on that?
I will. I certainly will. Yes. Okay. I'm going to talk about the Knight Templars, and the reason it's important is because they were the teachers of this esoteric knowledge. The Knight Templars' inner circle was made up of seven outer circles, and those within these circles were taught the minor mysteries. And those individuals within the three inner circles worked with the greater mysteries, okay? It is the same within Freemasonry and all the secret societies of today, for there is always an inner and an outer power structure. And that's why a lot of times your second, third, fourth degree Masons, they have no clue what's going on. And those within other secret societies, they have no clue because they're the outer power structure. They're not the inner power structure.
Hmm.
Outer circle is the covering for what is really going on at the deeper levels within the secret societies. Some of the higher knowledge inherited by the Knight Templars was that of the Earth energy grid. This is very important to understand what's going on at the spiritual level. You have to understand the Earth energy grid. It's a network of magnetic energy lines known as ley lines, dragon layers, or meridians. Okay. Thousands and thousands of cathedrals and temples and churches have been built on ancient pagan religious seraphlex. Okay.
Wait a minute. Cisco, repeat that, what you just said. I want to be clear on what you said.
Okay.
You said cathedrals and what else was built on what?
Okay. On these dragon lairs or these dragon lines. Or ley lines, thousands and thousands of cathedrals, temples, churches have been built on ancient pagan religious seraphlex. Washington, D.C., all of its capital buildings were built on these ley lines. Okay? I'll go into that in a little bit. Okay? It's within the Earth's etheric highway. It's called an etheric highway that many of these lines cross, creating huge vortexes or negative energy. So these aliens that the world wants to call them, which are really demons, they produce a negative energy. everything that is not of God. It's the dark forces. And throughout the world, those within the Illuminati have been given access to these tunnels, and they know where these ley lines intersect. It's really important that you understand that. Those that practice witchcraft, they have been trained. They know where the ley lines are.
So let me ask you real quick. These ley lines, you're saying underneath these cathedrals and temples across the world, these ley lines, there's underground tunnels. Is that what you're saying?
Yes. Yes. It is within and upon these energy vortexes that black magic rituals, human sacrifices are performed. These high-powered vortexes have intersections, dragon lines that interconnect with the dragon layers that make up the electric, now remember this word, electromagnetic grid that surrounds the planet. These interconnecting ley lines come together to form a web or grid of magnetic energy. Universal life forces naturally flow along these lines, and then they surround it and make its way into the Earth's etheric highway. Are you still with me?
Yeah, I'm just trying to put all of this together. This is some heavy information. These ley lines, you said it's creating a grid, if you will, like a magnetic grid.
Mm-hmm.
And they're drawing energy from this, right?
Right.
Evil energy.
Right. And that's how they keep their etheric bodies. That's how these aliens can take a human form. They use this energy. Okay.
Continue, Cisco, please.
I'm trying to think of where I want to go. These serpents of old and those within the white brotherhood understand arcane knowledge. Remember, this is arcane knowledge. This isn't knowledge that you're going to learn in school. They knew long ago that the dragons that were living within each dragon lair took the shape of a serpentine spiral of energy. This is the energy. This is the spiritual energy, the dark forces. These great masters of the arcane have always had the ability to spiritually see its spiritual spiraling etheric body take the shape of a serpentine spiral of energy. Remember I told you they could take any form?
Mm-hmm. Yep. So when you take that into consideration, Cisco, these power grids, and then you look at the way that the nation's capital was built,
mm-hmm.
Like you said here, what you sent me in the case of Washington, D.C., Masonic planners originally conceived that the street designs of the capital will be laid out in the most powerful satanic symbols possible. So you're saying that the entire federal government complex would reverberate with satanic power every day of the year?
Absolutely. 24 hours a day.
And also you wrote to me this continuous flow of power directly from Lucifer himself would gradually and inevitably move this country in the direction of the occult and will give its leaders the most incredible power as they deal with the leaders of other nations.
That's right.
That's a powerful statement, Cisco. And if we could, as we're coming close on a break here, let's let that sink in there for a minute to my listeners, because when you look at the direction that the United States have been going over the past, I say, 40 years or so, and we're going to a commercial break right now, but just give you some food for thought when we come back. You look at the direction that the country has been going in the past 30 to 40 years. We've come out of morals and values that were once good, but now everything that's bad is now good, and everything that is bad, I mean, you guys get what I'm saying. We'll be back. It's Flow of Wisdom. Welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am your host, Sean Anthony. And again, let me just quote a verse that I referenced at the beginning of the show. It came out of Ephesians chapter 5. And I'm just going to read here verse 11, or 10 and 11, proving what is acceptable unto the Lord. Verse 11, and have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them. And, you know, I don't want people to get it twisted thinking that, you know, oh man, Sean, you're just highlighting, you know, the evil, you know, the Satanists and Luciferianism and all of that. No, I mean, I'm exposing it. I'm bringing it to the forefront because oftentimes sometimes people are afraid to tackle these subjects. And that's something that I'm not afraid to tackle. And my guest, Cisco Wheeler, has come on again to expose these things. She was in it. She was in it for years. And she's gotten out of it. So she's been spending her life, you know, exposing it. She wrote a book entitled Behold a White Horse. It's available online. And, you know, this is her third time on the show. And, you know, every time she comes on, it's some heavy information. It's not for the, you know, the faint-hearted. You know, this is a very short segment, Cisco. So we're not going to get very long-winded on this one because we're going to, you know, continue this discussion into the second hour.
Okay.
But some of the things I want to highlight here. You said that Satanists believe that once a satanic symbol is drawn on the ground, it begins to reverberate with the cult power 7 days a week, 24 hours per day. And in rituals, the witch, you know, almost always draw a powerful symbol on the ground from which he or she will conduct the ceremony. Now, when we look at hip hop culture or look at popular culture right now, and you see the images being used in rap videos and pop videos, because I don't want to just put rap and hip hop, but just in popular culture today, there's a lot of occultic symbols. And some people will dismiss it and say, oh, come on, guys, you guys are looking into it too deep. You know, it's not that serious. Well, you're telling me that Satanists believe that once a satanic symbol is drawn on the ground, it begins to reverberate with occult power, correct?
That's correct.
So, briefly, what do you say to somebody that would say, man, come on, that would see an occultic symbol, you know, on television or in a music video or on somebody's clothes, a T-shirt, and say, man, come on, Sean, it's not that serious, man. It's just a symbol. You know, it's just a symbol from Egypt. You know, don't think of it. It's not that serious. What would you say to somebody like that? What would be your brief response?
It's so serious that it'll destroy and rob you of your children's spiritual ability to seek God out. It literally destroys the frontal lobe, that part of the brain that God made that helps us interact with God Almighty in the spiritual realm. It destroys the front lobal brain. That's a whole different topic. You could write a book on it. It's very serious. It steals the souls of our children. And sin gets deeper and deeper and deeper. God gets bigger and sin gets deeper.
Well, real quick, Cisco, before we go to close out this hour, we're going to pick this up in the second hour. What do you say to my listeners that have been caught up, that want to turn away? They want to repent and turn from their wicked ways. What do you say to them? What encouraging words?
God is so merciful, and he loves us so much that he can heal us. He can heal those wounds. We can close those doors that have been opened to the mind for the demonic realm to work. We can ask the Lord to close those realms and those openings that are in our brain that we are continually spiritually attacked.
That's right. Amen. All right, we're going to close this hour, guys. Hour number two, we're going to pick up right where we left off with Cisco Wheeler. And for those that are listening to this, you know, and you have some questions or what have you, feel free to hit me up, flowofwisdom.com. There's a contact page. I'm on Twitter. Shoot me a tweet at Sean_Anthony. Stick around for hour number two as we continue to expose the tactics of the enemy. I'm Sean Anthony. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. Get motivated.
voted.